Hello and welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Gwenfar, which will be, I think, the final episode of this series. And the reason for that is not because I'm tired of it or that we have done too many episodes already, but that's the other reason that in a few days there will be Farm Sim 19. And I don't think I will play 17 again anytime soon, so might as well just tell you guys that this will be the last episode for Gwenfar. I do have a plan to upload something different this week before the launch of 19, and that's my other single player game. I'm also doing rather slow, but some work on Stappenbach, on the newest version of Stappenbach. I run a farm which has some cows, and they reproduce. I think it's called a beef farm in the map, with some mother cows, and then they produce little cows, and you sell those as a profit. And we mainly grow potatoes, and grain, because that's what they eat. Potatoes, grain, they need straw, they produce slurry and manure. I can use the slurry and I can sell the manure, or some of the plants will be buying the composter, and then we can convert the manure into compost and sell the compost, which will sell for more. Anyway, back to Gwenfar. You were just in time to join me finishing up the plowing on field 21. Oh, and I need some diesel as well. So yeah, we bought field 21. We sold field 4. Ooh, and apparently we also own field 2. I've never been to field 2. Something changed there, because I didn't think we owned that one. So yeah, the plan was to sell field 4 and 1, but as field 1's entrance is through the sheep, the little sheep, not the art or farm, but yeah, the place where the wool spawns, that wouldn't be a good idea to sell field 1. Maybe you can just rent it to somebody else, but yeah, field 4 has different entrances, so no problem in selling that. And with the money from field 4, we bought field 21, plowed it for grain, still need to cultivate it for the grain, and this field is ready, is cultivated. And then yeah, the other field you can see here, which was a grass field, I also plowed for grain. Why so many grain, I hear you say? Well, because we need straw and we need something to sell. And why do we need the straw? For these guys, or girls, because I think they're all girls. Probably not gonna get any milk from a bull. It's gonna give you some issues if you try. So yeah, oh yeah, have these been fermented yet? Yep, they are fermented, so we can give them to the cows as well, because they now only have water over here and grass that they need to get themselves. It's the grazing mod, yeah, 26,000 liter is in here, so that's plenty. Don't need to give them any hay for now, because I have the mod where the grass and the hay is in the same category. Which, if you ask me, feels a bit more accurate. Because animals during the year they spend outside, eat the grass, and you give them silage or total mixed ration. And I believe in winter, when they're inside, you also give them some hay. But you don't give them a lot of hay on its own, I think, when they are outside. Time to get some gas. Alright. I think I know what happened. Because we also own field 7, 8 and 9 again, and 15 and 14. I think something happened to the XML file. And it's all back, because I changed that in the beginning of one of the first series. Where am I going? I was going to feed the cow some of those silage bales, so we need the front loader. And probably we need to drop this weight and put it on the back. No idea if this tractor can handle a heavy silage bale on its own. Oh, we also can sell. No, we can't sell the wool because that's somebody stole the front loader. I have no idea where it is now. Maybe it's on the back here. No. Nope. Oh yeah, we bought the coon, the cedar drill, this one. It comes with its own cultivator here on the front. It's a separate part, which is already attached. And we'll use that to get some grains in the ground. But first, we are on the mission to find the front loader. Yeah, maybe it's a lot easier to use this. Okay, it's fairly close. It's probably gonna be around the corner here, yeah. Nope. Oh boy, I see it. Here it is. Did I just do a dagger win? As in having it on the screen all the time, not seeing it. Hopefully I'm getting his subscribes also then. Anyway, let's grab some bales now. And since I've been playing Destiny a while, I have no idea how to do this anymore. Okay, press X. X to lock. Yep, that's it. Where can we give them here? Let's try. Yep, that works. No need for a mixer. Good. Check it out. It's already plenty. Yeah, we only have 10 cows, so that's plenty here. We don't have any straw. That's okay. That's a few extra percentage that we lose on the production, and no manure. But it's okay. Let's put that front loader back where it came from. And try to remember it for next time. There will be no next time. change that again because it's slightly a heavy seed drill that we will be putting on the back here. I hope we still have some seed. Yep, we do. Let's back up to the seat and then load it up. So there's no fertilizer on this one. I believe there is a version with fertilizer, but yeah, we are not using that, and that's also slightly more heavy, of course. So as we need straw, I think it's either grain, the wheat or the barley, and let's start with the barley. So let's go along with the furrows, or it will be very extremely bumpy. Do we have GPS? No. But I have a good imagination, so let's use it anyway. Put it on one of the furrows for measurement. Yep, that's fine. Line up. Leave some room for the headlands. Switch on. Don't wanna be sticking in my hand or anything down there. Set on the ground now. Yep. There we go. I like this this mod here. I think I have two of them. The Coon and then another brand. And they come with what you call it, power thingy, power harrow or something. It cultivates the ground before before the seed goes in. See the PTO move nicely. So yeah, I am pretty much used to use a lot of mods. And yeah, we all know what will happen when MS-19 hits. There won't be any mods for at least a day. So I'll have to see if I can manage the first day without a mod. I probably will, because I think I told it earlier that I have people over at the office and I have a very busy week. And also there's Northside Farming Group, so if you want to join, maybe it's a nice time to check out our thread on FS UK or on the Giants forum and apply for a position. Then you can already have a chat in Discord with the guys. We're all doing our thing now. Some are doing ETS, some are doing ATS or other games, or some are still in farms in 17 on the server, because we have a save game running. I think it's Meadow Grove Farm something. I haven't been online because I wanted to check out some mods I had for ages that I didn't use because of my time on the multiplayer server. So yeah, that's still open for positions for recruitment, and maybe not a bad time to start together with a new game. It will be a new game, new map. We will run, of course, a few days vanilla, so we can get our bearings together. I'll probably be there, and I'll probably be recording as well, and I might be doing some single player sessions too, because I really want to look at the fact that you can start as a contractor, and I did that in FS17 too. That was nice, don't get me wrong, but yeah, you had to do a lot of things and imagine a lot of things to make it work. So hopefully in FS19 it's a lot easier to do that. And yeah, we'll soon find out. But since it's not there yet, we are stuck with this, which is of course fine. We've been playing this quite some time now. As a matter of fact, I'll have to check my Steam account. Yeah, FS15 I had 621 hours in Steam, and FS17 it's 1948 hours. So 52 hours to go and I'll hit the 2000 hour in Farm Sim 17. That's both multiplayer, single player, no player. So yeah. Anyway, I'll continue a bit offline and call you back in when I want to say something, or when we're done, or when I've crashed. I do hope that in 19 you can change your controls while in game, like in the menu. If you do escape, then you can change your controls. That's one of the things I really miss in 17, especially when you are setting up something new, like joystick or whatever. You just can't do it in 17, which is really strange for a game of this period, 2017-18. I think most of the games you can do that since ages, since I can't remember since when. So let's hope you can in the next version. So we'll continue here a bit until it gets darker, or until my farmer here gets too hungry and needs to grab a bite. And yeah, you might think that's no reason why you are doing seeding the grain here, because it's the last episode and you won't be able to harvest it anymore. But yeah, it's a game and we enjoy playing it, whether you've ended selling everything and moving on, or whether you end it in the middle of whatever, like seeding barley. So no class in 19. There's a big hype around John Deere being in 19. To be honest, it's nice and okay for the guys that are on console or don't run mods, but for me, frankly, I don't really care that much what brands are in there, because I will use the default in-game equipment for a few days, maybe a few weeks, but then overall we use modded tractors anyway, because of all the extra bits they do. Usually a good modded tractor just beats default game one hands down. They are so nice, they are so good. Also the IC here, where you can interactive control, where you can open a door. You can't do that on a default tractor, and might sound stupid, but it's a thing. Yeah, you miss that when you go to when you go to a default game tractor. Yeah, it's nice, but then you're like, it's missing all these things. So yeah, when you're able to use the mods, you don't really want to go back. I hope Seasons doesn't take too long. Just playing the game without Seasons, that's, yeah, easy mode, even easier than easy. Then it's a bit too much arcade for me. When Seasons really changed Farm Simulator into a simulator. And I know, is their lead designer from Realismus Modding, or one of the guys is working for Farms for Giants now, but as far as I know, that's not his main thing he's working on Seasons. I think he has different things to do. But maybe being on the inside, it's slightly easier to start early with Seasons on his own time. Okay, maybe it's a bit silly to end the series like this. So yeah, maybe I'll do another episode soon. But I can't promise it, because I don't know if I'll have time to do it. But when I do, I will upload another episode. Maybe I'll fast forward the game time, and then you can perhaps see the harvest here, because we haven't seen a harvest. We saw plenty of mowing and raking and deading and mowing and baling, but we haven't seen a harvest here yet. And on my series of Steppenbach, I just did a grain harvest, so that will also be a while before I can do that again over there. You could join a potato harvest, and then I can use a bit of the potato stuff that I didn't use a lot. Only recently find out that there's even default in game a thing for the potatoes that puts it into crates. I had no idea, never used it, so I will use that. And then I could record it so you guys can see it as well. And I think by the time I did one or two episodes on Stappen Bath, I'm sure, and maybe another one on here, and then I'm sure that FS19 will be available. And yeah, I better start recording on there then. Or you might all end up going to another YouTuber. Don't. Or do, but stay with me as well. Yeah. So we're almost done here. And that's good, because it's getting dark. I had to put on the extra work lights. And we're almost out of seat. So I think I won't do the headlands on this field. I will need a refill, and yeah, we'll finish up here. We'll have another look at the bees and see how they are. That's only 5 more liters of seed. At least I think it's liters. That will be done in no time. 2, 1, and we're out. So let's park up. Oh yeah, or wash it first. My son will go nuts. Because he's always angry that my tractors are filthy. Even when we just washed it and I drive off, then he says I need to wash it again because the tires are filthy. So yeah, this is the Kuhn, the combi liner. It's a nice little equipment for smaller farms. And yeah, I like it that it has a ability to attach a power harrow. That's the word. Getting tired, I think. Yeah, we have the tire pressure thing as well here. Hi, that's it. Haven't used this a lot. Sure they don't explode. That's the maximum. So let's park it up. I'll just leave everything attached, put it under cover. There we go, and go check out the bees. No, there's not much to look at. These guys just keep on working in the background. They just keep flying, getting in the honey. And they also go to the store and sell the honey. It is nice of them. And gives us that little income. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys, and yeah, maybe another episode soon. Maybe time will have advanced a few days or months. I think months, and then maybe we can do a harvest and sell the wood, and then we are ready to close down this farm. because yeah, we haven't sold any wool yet, and we were, we did start as a sheep farm. And a sheep farm that's not selling any wool, that's a bit odd. So yeah, I thank you guys. See you soon, hopefully. So take care. Bye-bye.